Hey everybody, it's Sammy here from the Perot Museum of Nature and Science, and it's Paleo Week this week, so I thought what could be cooler than going on a fossil excavation together where none of us even have to leave our homes. So I've got my field hat on, go grab yours and let's get started.
Since we can't really get into the field, we're gonna have to use our imagination, so I want everyone to close their eyes. Imagine a postcard landscape where together we're gonna look for fossils. Whoa, what's that over there? You spot something sticking out of the side of those rocks. Could it be? It is! It's a fossil! Okay, now open your eyes. Yeah, I know, not what you were picturing, but it's always nice to have a scientific excuse to bake some cookies. Our cookie is our rock, or the outcrop. The chocolate chips, those are the fossils, and we have to get them out. Now, paleontologists, such as ourselves, use a number of tools to get fossils out of the earth. What do you think about this one, my rock hammer? What about this sledgehammer? How about these chisels? Yeah, you're right, probably not the best tools for the job. Now these look a lot better. Remember, we don't want to crush our fossils. Now paleontologists, like our team at the Perot Museum of Nature and Science, they use all sorts of amazing tools to get fossils back from the field, prepped in our paleo lab, and then put on display for all of you to admire. Some of these tools can even get pretty silly, like porcupine quills or sticks to hold the jacket together. No, not that kind of jacket. A field jacket, or a plaster support that helps keep fossils protected while they're transported out of the field and back to our prep labs. Some of these field jackets can weigh hundreds of pounds, and it's pretty dangerous work to get them out of the field, as you can see. I hope you all had some fun excavating our imaginary fossils together. I think I'll call mine Chalkosaurus. See you next time when we get to amaze our brains together at home.